Hello students, today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is financial market, chapter 10. So we'll discuss that what financial market is, right? A financial market is a market for the creation and exchange of financial assets. So it's a market where we create and we exchange financial assets, right? Now what financial asset is? Financial asset are the shares, debentures, or any kind of securities, right? So it's a market where we create such assets and we exchange such assets. Creation of financial assets means we issue shares, debentures, or any other security in financial market. How we exchange these financial assets? We purchase and sale of existing shares, debentures, or securities. So for these two purposes, there are two main players, you can say, or there are main two sectors which participate in, you know, the financial market as a buyers and sellers, you can say. The first one is the households and the second one is the business firms, right? These households, they have the funds with them, they have, you know, funds with them, surplus funds with them, and they are called savers, right? So households, they do saving, fine, that's why they are called savers. And the business firms, or you can say the borrowers, fine, they invest the fund and they are called as investors. Okay, now financial market has a primary function that is called the allocative function. Financial market has an allocative function. And what allocative function is? Allocative function means that this financial market, it links the savers and the investors by mobilizing the funds between them. So this financial market, it plays an allocative function, right, by linking, means it financial market brings together the savers and the investors together to mobilize funds, right? Means the savers, they save money in the banks, and the, you know, the borrowers, they borrow money, and again they become investors, they invest money, fine, to provide profit to these savers, fine. This is one more definition. What is financial intermediation? It is the process by which allocation of funds is done, right? How these investors, they invest, you know, money of the savers in different funds, how they allocate, that process is called the financial intermediation or the allocation of funds, fine. Now we'll you know, discuss in detail that how these two main sectors in the economy, they operate or they work, fine. We have business firms first, and we have household savers. They are the savers, they have surplus money with them, they have surplus fund with them, that's why they are called surplus units, okay. And the second one is, the second sector, that is called the business firms, entrepreneurs, deficit units, or you can say the borrowers, fine. So what do? They, these household savers, they provide, right, or they save the surplus fund in the banks. Banks generally induce these household savers by providing good rate of interest, fine. So they induce their savings, they invite them, the household savers, not to keep their money idle at their homes, but to invest that into the bank and to earn good profit as interest, right? So they save money in banks, and what bank does? Banks, they provide the money which they receive from these household savers, they provide that money to these business firms, because these business firms, they need money, they need money, and they are called the deficit unit because they require more money, fine. So that's why they are called the deficit unit. So what bank is doing? Bank is actually receiving money from the surplus unit and allocating, or you can say giving, lending that amount to the deficit unit, that is called the business firm or the entrepreneurs. Fine. And you will see that in what banks they are doing, actually banks are helping these business firms or the entrepreneurs to increase the production of goods and services. Fine. How? Because these business firms, they require money to purchase real assets. Fine. Real assets are plant, machinery, land, right? At the same time, they invest that borrowed amount, fine, to increase their wealth, fine. So this is the one function. The second function is these firms, first they raise money through these banks, first financial institutions, second they raise money, or the business firms or the deficit unit, they raise money by issuing shares or debentures or any kind of securities in the financial market, right? They raise money by issuing shares, debentures in the financial market. Again, these two players, they are there, right? They are also there, right? These household savers, not only they invest their money in bank, but they also invest their money in purchasing the securities, shares or debentures. So these business units, they are fetching money through the household savers by two different mediums.